So you may already know about Activity Monitor. It's an app that's on your Mac that allows you to monitor CPU use, energy use, disk use on your Mac. Let's run it here. I'm going to use Spotlight. So Command Space, search for Activity Monitor, and run it. And you can see I get a list of processes. It's very technical. I can go to CPU use, memory use, energy use, disk use, network use. I get graphs and things at the bottom. If you're a developer like myself, it's somewhat useful. Typical Mac users don't really need it, but if you suspect a process is using a lot of power or battery on your MacBook, you may want to monitor it and use this as a tool for that. One of the really cool things about it is you don't have to have this big window open here all the time with this list of processes. It's pretty complex. You can instead use the dock. See, I've got the dock icon here for Activity Monitor, and it's a static icon. But it doesn't have to be. You can actually set it to show you information. So, for instance, I can, in Activity Monitor, go to View, and then there's a dock icon option here. And I could say, Show Disk Activity. And I get a graph now that's going to continuously update, showing me disk activity. And it matches the graph shown here. So I can see here, you know, the reads and writes, blue for reads, red for writes, and there's the graph in Activity Monitor, and it's the same as in the dock. But I could hide Activity Monitor, so I'm going to use Command H to hide, or I could go to this menu here, Hide Activity Monitor. And now it's hidden, it doesn't get in my way, but the icon still is there. I could also change to show other things, like for instance, I could do network usage. And that's going to spike when it's reading or writing to the internet for various different things. So loading web pages, for instance, I would see it spike for reads. I can also go to CPU history. So it's going to give me a graph that's the same as this here. And it's going to start at the beginning, so it's going to start building it up. So as I'm doing various things, maybe rendering video in Final Cut or audio in GarageBand, things like that, I'm going to see CPU use jump. And then lastly, I've got an option for CPU use without the history. So it's just a little meter. So right now it's at the bottom, but if I were to be using a lot of CPU, it would jump up towards the top. So this is really handy. You can hide or minimize the Activity Monitor and leave this down here. It has to be running. So if I quit, it's gone from the dock. Even if I were to put the Activity Monitor in the dock by dragging it over to the left there, when I quit, it just goes back to the default icon. It has to be running to monitor these things and update its dock icon. But it's a handy little tool if you need to monitor your Mac's CPU use or some other use while you're working without having that big window getting in the way.